Hello everyone, welcome to Kamat Astrology, and today I will cover one more topic, that is understanding the characteristics of Uttar Bhadrapada Nakshatra. Now this diagram shows us where exactly the Uttar Bhadrapada Nakshatra lies. So Uttar Bhadrapada Nakshatra lies in the Meen Rashi, that is the 12th house in the natural zodiac, between 3 degrees 20 minutes and 16 degrees 40 minutes. So you can see two purple lines inside the Meen Rashi, and the area between these two purple lines is nothing but the Uttar Bhadrapada Nakshatra. So the Uttar Bhadrapada Nakshatra entirely lies in the zodiac sign of Meen or Pisces. Now remember that the sign of Meen or Pisces is ruled by Jupiter or Guru, okay? And Meen Rashi is a watery sign. Now this water represents the spiritual depths. Now look at how this nakshatra looks like in the sky, okay? So it looks like the two legs of a funeral cot. The back two legs of the funeral cot are considered very auspicious, and so this nakshatra also means the second of the blessed feet, okay, or the one whose feet are very auspicious, okay. So this represents blessed feet or auspicious feet. Now who is the ruling graha of this nakshatra? Okay, the ruling graha of this nakshatra is none other than Shani or Saturn, okay? And the ruling deity of this nakshatra is someone called as Ahir Budhyana. I will explain what exactly is Ahir Budhyana shortly. The animal representation of this nakshatra is a cow, okay? So people born in this nakshatra, they are also considered to be as holy as the cow. Okay, now let me explain the characteristics of the ruling deity of this nakshatra. The ruling deity of this nakshatra is a mystic god called Ahir Budhyana. Okay, Ahir Budhyana is nothing but an underwater serpent. That is a serpent who lives deep under the seas and looks after the treasures in the seas. Okay, so this serpent has a lot of treasures. Now because this serpent lives under the seas, this under the seas, whatever water is there, that is the spiritual water, okay? So this serpent represents fertility, all right, or it represents Kundalini Shakti. Now Kundalini Shakti is the divine energy that lies at the base of the spine, okay? And when this Shakti is activated and it reaches the highest chakra, which is located in our brain called Sahasra, okay, we get moksha. So this deity has the capacity to give moksha. It is actually a form of Rudra, okay? So this is a combined form of Rudra and Shakti, and it represents fertility or the Kundalini energy which lies dormant within all of us. Now remember that this serpent lies deep in the spiritual waters, okay? So people born in this nakshatra, they are influenced by Saturn as well as by Ahir Budhyana, okay? Saturn represents mysticism from the perspective of Meen Rashi. Meen Rashi represents spiritual waters. So people born in the Uttar Bhadrapada nakshatra, they have a tendency to go deep inside and analyze things, okay? So they can be mystics, they can be well versed with occult practices, okay? They can be astrologers, somebody who can look deep inside within himself, who is drawn towards spirituality naturally. That is the characteristic of this Uttar Bhadrapada nakshatra. Ahir Budhyana is the guardian of treasures within the sea, okay? In a similar way, these people have a lot of knowledge within themselves, okay? So when you look at them, you may not realize that, but they are very knowledgeable. They have intense knowledge within them. Now another symbol for this nakshatra is a set of twins. Okay, so what this means is there is duality present within these individuals. Okay, so as I said earlier, these individuals have the ability to delve deep within themselves. This means they can be mystics, they can be healers, they can be occult practitioners. Okay, now occult practices are of two kinds. The good side is drawn towards astrology, is drawn towards the divine god. Okay, and the negative side of occult practices is something called as tantra or maili vidya. Okay, so it is quite possible that people born in this nakshatra are attracted towards tantra or maili vidya. Okay, a kind of knowledge by which you can harm someone indirectly. So you can see that twins look very alike, but their characteristics can be entirely different. One can be very good, the other fellow can be very bad. Okay, and this is a special feature of Uttar Bhadrapada nakshatra. So depending on which planet is present in the Uttar Bhadrapada nakshatra apart from the moon, okay, for example, if Rahu or Ketu is present in the Uttar Bhadrapada nakshatra, there is quite a tendency to move either towards the bad occult practices or to move towards spirituality. When Ketu is there, you may move towards moksha. Okay, you may get detached from the material world, and when Rahu is there, you can be drawn towards the material world. Okay, so you may indulge in negative things like tantra if Rahu is present in this nakshatra in the sign of Meen. Now, what are the good professions for people born in Uttar Bhadrapada nakshatra? Okay, they can be healers, they can be tarot card readers, they can be astrologers. Okay, they can be very good teachers, philosophers and psychiatrists, because they have the ability to delve deep within themselves. They also have the ability to empathize with others. So guys, this is my analysis of characteristics of people born with Uttar Bhadrapada nakshatra. My contact details are given in this slide. In case of any queries, please write to me at astrosevaworld@yahoo.com. You can also reach out to us through our website astroseva.tripod.com or our mobile application Kamath Astrology on Google Play Store. Feel free to subscribe to this channel by hitting the subscribe button so that whenever I add a new video, you are automatically notified. So guys, thanks a lot. Hope you enjoyed this video. See you soon with another video. Till then, bye. Take care. Enjoy your weekend.